Hello students, in this lecture we are going to see about your memory hierarchy. So before that, first we are going to see about the characteristics of your memory, how the memories are characterized. The memories are generally characterized as here based on your storage capacity, unit of transfer, access mode, access time, permanence of storage, cycle time, data transfer time and physical characteristics. So the first characteristics is the storage capacity. The storage capacity represents the size of your memory. The size of the internal memory can be expressed in terms of number of cores or byte. Second one is a unit of transfer. The unit of transfer is nothing but how much number of bit at a time we are going to read or write from your memory. That means how much data we are going to transfer from CPU to memory or memory to CPU. For a main memory or internal memory, the normal unit of information transfer is equal to the word length of the process. That is, it depends upon the data line in the system. Next one is access mode. So in the lecture 1 we saw about the access mode. The access mode, there are three types: direct access, random access and sequential access. So the access mode is in what way we are going to access your data from the memory. So the information from the memory is accessed in the form of direct, random or in sequential. In what manner we are going to access your data from your memory. Next one is your access time. The access time is nothing but the how much time required between the request made by a processor and the data, at what time the data is available at the requested location. That is nothing called as your access time. So it is generally how much time required between the request made for the operation, that is the CPU wants to read or write, and the time the data is available at the requested location. Suppose the processor wants to read any data from your memory, means at what time the data request is made, at what time the data is available. That is the access time. So next one is the permanence of the storage. Some memories can lose the information over the period of the time. That means the how long the data is remain stored in your memory. So that is nothing but your permanence of your storage. For example, take this DRAM or volatile RAM and hardware failure and destructive reload. If these things are in this types of the memory, that is the DRAM, the data is not remained for all the time. The data is lost over a period of the time. It is just like a volatile memory. Then hardware, due to the hardware failure also, the data will be erased from the memory. So next one is your cycle time. The cycle time is your defined as the minimum time elapsed between two consecutive read requests. The processor wants to read your data, means it will read the data one by one from the processor. What is the time gap between your two read or any operation? That is nothing but your cycle time. Next one is a data transfer. The data transfer is nothing but at a time how much amount of data we are transferring. That is called as your data transfer time. That is the amount of data transferred per unit time. Always it is measured in the terms of bit per second. The how many number of bit transferred per second. Already we know about that bit. The data transfer is always mentioned in the form of bit per seconds only. Next one is the physical characteristics. The physical characteristics is nothing but in what way, what technology the memories are manufactured. So the variety of physical types of memory are in use. For example, a semiconductor memory. In a semiconductor memory, we are using a VLSI technology. The next physical types of memory is a magnetic surface. The magnetic surface is used for a disk and tape manufacturing. So these are the general characteristics of your memory. So if you take any memory, these are the general characteristics: the storage capacity, the how much data we are going to read or return in a single read and write operation, in what way we are going to access your data, then how much time required to access their data. Next one is a permanence of storage, that means the how long the data is stored in your memory. Then cycle time is the time with gap between your two consecutive read or write operation. Then data transfer time, the how much time it need to transfer your data. Next one is a physical characteristics, that is a what types of technology or that is types of semi memory unit we are using, either semiconductor memory or magnetic disk or CD-ROM like that. So these are the general characteristics of memory. So next we are going to see about memory hierarchy. So the memory hierarchy is nothing but the way the memory system is organized in a computer, that is called as a memory hierarchy. So the main objective of the memory hierarchy is to increase the speed of your access time, increase the access speed. So that is the main objective of the memory hierarchy. So it will minimize the total cost of the memory system. So the main thing about the memory hierarchy is it balancing the performance with cost. For example, if you are using a small memory, means it is very fast but expensive. So next one is, if you are using a large memory, means it will be very slow but it is a cheap. The example for the small memory is a caching memory. The caching memory is very fast but it is a very expensive and size also small. Then the large memory, the example for large memory is your secondary memory. The secondary memory is very slow but it is very cheap. So the basic principle of the memory hierarchy is locality of a reference. So locality of a reference is nothing but the reuse or nearness of the access. So second one is, it must allow the access the data, use a small and fast memory. This is a diagram of a memory hierarchy, in what layer, in which level the memory is organized, that is in what way the memory system is organized. So the topmost one is a register. The register is inside the processor. So the CPU, the register, it will store the data temporarily. That means, so whatever the program executed by a CPU, the data are temporarily stored in a register. The register is very costly compared to the secondary memory, that is compared to the second level, that is a caching memory. So the caching memory, the caching memory is a very fast memory compared to the main memory. The caching memory is placed between your CPU register and your main memory. The caching memory is a built by means of using a SRAM. SRAM is a static RAM. Then the level 3 is your main memory. So the main memory is a manufactured by means of using a DRAM. That is a dynamic RAM. The SRAM and dynamic RAMs are a volatile memory. And then the level 4 is your local secondary storage. It is called that is local secondary storage. In this local secondary storage, it stores the operating system and all. Then the fifth level is a remote secondary storage. The remote secondary storage is nothing but the device which is not direct, always not connected in your computer. The example for the remote secondary storage is here our pin drive and all. That is an example for the remote secondary storage. That is the example of tapes, distributed file system, web servers. So these are your remote secondary storage. This is a memory hierarchy diagram. In the memory hierarchy diagram, here the memory hierarchy is nothing but the organize the memory system in a level is called a memory hierarchy. In a memory hierarchy, once it goes top to bottom, the cost is decreasing from the top to bottom. So compared to the register and caching memory, main memory, the cost of the secondary memory is here very less. That is, the cost per bit is very less. And you compare from the top to bottom, the capacity will be increased. The capacity of your secondary storage is very high compared to the top level. Top level is nothing but main memory, caching memory and CPU register. Then accessing time. So the accessing time, that is from top to bottom, it will increases the accessing time. The CPU always access the data from a caching memory in order to increases the access time. In order to increases the not the access time, in order to increases your access speed. So these are this is a diagram of your memory hierarchy. In what way the memory is arranged in your computer. Okay, so please attend, try to answer for these questions. Thank you.